Hello, everybody, and welcome to Penn State Ice Lions Hockey. My name is Ethan Zaretsky, and joined alongside me today is a new face in the broadcasting booth, Matthew Cabron. Matt, how you doing today?
I'm stoked for this game, Ethan. I mean, you've been asking me for, honestly, since last year to join you for these Ice Lion games. Here I am. This is my 30 event of the day, and guess what? It's my best event of the day. It's the main event. We got Penn State Ice Lions Hockey against the Army Black Knights, and it doesn't get better than this, Ethan. I mean, look at these two teams. We have the 2-3-0 Ice Lions here at home, and they're facing the 3-1-1 Army here. Should be a good one.
Absolutely, Matt. Great analysis there. As we send you ice level to the game, we have both starting lineups tonight in net for both teams. The Penn State Ice Lions starting John Seafarth this weekend, first game for Seafarth against Army. They have a two-game set coming up this weekend. First game is weekend set for puck drops. Ice Lions are going to start out with their opening line featuring Evan Partridge, centering Brendan Meyer and Joey Vilardi, and we are off. Both teams looking to get a head start. Army, one of the biggest teams that I've seen, and early we have a chance for Brendan Meyer. That puck was to the left of the net of the goalie tonight for Army, the Black Knights. It is going to be Liam Monahan getting the start and the nod. Very interesting. I was talking to the coaches before the game that all three goalies are freshmen. That's really interesting, man.
And that's a big opportunity here for the Ice Lions. You know, they got some young guppies out on the ice, you know. Big opportunity here for them to hopefully take a win against a team where, I mean, Ethan, we've been here for a while now. We saw Army during the pregame. This Army team looks very big, and they look very, you know, they want to push this physical presence here tonight against the Ice Lions.
I mean, they literally have a defensive pair that they call the Milkmen. So be prepared to see Brendan Connor and Barrett Connor, both the brothers, going at it defensively tonight for the Black Knights as there's a face-off to the left of Seafarth. Going to get things going as the top line for the Ice Lions remains out there. Top line for Army is going to be Ben Gosher centering Mark Lehman and Charlie Aronoff. Defensive partner to start there for the Black Knights is Anthony Chambers and Wyatt Sinatris. We appreciate all you guys for tuning in to today's broadcast between the Penn State Ice Lions and the Army Black Knight. Going to be an interesting series so far as Army and the Ice Lions try to get each other working here early in this game. Army gets off for a full change, gets their second unit out there, as do the Ice Lions. Sebastian Kylie in yesterday's 8-0 victory for the Ice Lions up against Denison had a hat trick with two shorthanded goals. Played absolutely outstanding for Penn State in that win against Denison as Luke Raimundo has an opportunity on the backhand, just can't get it to the goalie Monahan. Another backhander there by Kylie, who I was just talking to, unable to get a shot there on Monahan. Now a battle for the puck in the near boards as three Black Knights go up against two Ice Lions. Digging for the puck is Kylie and able to squirt it out there to safety for the Black Knights. Going the other way is James D'Elia. Unable to get offense generated there as quickly turned back the other way are the Ice Lions, sending it down the length of the ice. There was Matthew Knysner. That fourth line for the Ice Lions yesterday played extremely well. Those guys featuring Xander Faust, Alec Riggle, and Ethan Szymanski. Had a chance to talk to Xander before the game. He says he feels really good after the game that he had yesterday in that 8-0 victory versus Denison. But just looking to carry the momentum here into this weekend's game versus Army.
And Ethan, the number one thing here for the Ice Lions is it's really good when you win 8-0. Coach is very happy, but guess what? You can't come out the next day and be flat. So they got to be, you know, we talked to Coach earlier in the pregame, you know, pucks in deep. They got to be really fast with their decisions. And, you know, hopefully, you know, anything they can do here to take this win tonight against the Army. The Black Knights, of course.
Yeah, absolutely, Matt. Great analysis there as the battle for the puck continues in Army's defensive zone as the third line for the Ice Lions out there. Alec Connolly centering Liam Egan, fresh in the lineup. Didn't play in yesterday's game against Denison. He was supporting the team from the bench. Carson Cabral downs the other forward on that one. And a big shout out to the family of Alex Mavris, that is, who came to the broadcast booth early from Australia. And Alec Connolly with an opportunity here, early shot on save by Monahan with the shoulder. Still 0-0 game here so far. 3 minutes into the first period as Army's looking to retreat, getting out of their defensive zone, chipping it out on the far side right in front of their bench. Now regrouping defensively for the Ice Lions is Nathaniel Schumann, who has the puck offensively, trying to get some offense. As both teams are really trying to figure out each other so far. It's two teams that don't play each other very often. They're just trying to get used to each other's play and, you know, developing into this, developing a speed and just trying to be comfortable in their own skates.
No, yeah, 100%, Ethan. I mean, you look at these two teams. I mean, Penn State, they started their season, I mean, three road losses to start the year. Now they're on a two-game heater. Hopefully they get a good early turning point of their season where if they can get a big win here against a big physical team like the Army Black Knights, they can definitely, you know, start their season off in a better foot, you know, start at 500 instead of, you know, that 0-3 deficit where they did start off at.
Yeah, those three losses coming to IUP and dropping one to NC State. The Ice Lions have won their two previous games, like I was just talking about. Dennison, as they have a man advantage here. Ethan Szymanski taking it in the zone, looking for an opportunity on the forehand, just throws it high on the net, and almost a save there by Monahan, unable to clear the puck. And now a chance here as the referee whistles it for a hand pass in Army's defensive zone.
What a rip there by Ethan Szymanski, oh, yeah. Ethan. I mean, hey, same namescape. And then, hey, when we go back to Army, I mean, you look at their schedule. They played Central Connecticut. They won 9-4 to start the year. And then they split against Rowan University, where they went 10. They had a 10-4 win and then a 4-3 overtime loss. And then they lost another game, but then they ended up bouncing back against Clarkson, where they split against them. So here they go on a breakaway,
Ethan. On a breakaway there, that was a great chance by Charlie Aronoff. The first line left winger for the Black Knights just missed the net there of Seafarth. Still 0-0, shots on goal 2-1 in favor of the Ice Lions. Here just a few minutes into this game, 15:30 remaining in the first period.
And if you're Seafarth there, Ethan, I mean, I know he hasn't played much so far this year, but I mean, you want those opportunities like that really early on to really test how he is going to play in this game against a big team like this.
Top line out now for the Ice Lions as Evan Partridge tries to put a couple nifty moves on the Black Knight defender, quickly taken away there by Anthony Chambers, the 195-pound defenseman from Greenwood Village, Colorado. Definitely a tongue twister there as the Black Knights are looking to change, dumping it in and getting some fresh legs out there, sending out their second unit of Caleb Kaiser, James D'Elia on the right, and Henry Miller on the left. Gotta love the style of the Black Knights jerseys. No last names on the back, just every jersey says West Point. So if you're trying to read the last names, they all say the same names.
And Penn State keeping it classic, the no names with the white jerseys. I mean, you can't get anything better than that, Ethan. I mean, we love the white jerseys here at Penn State.
Oh yeah, definitely matters. Kneisner throws one on net. A little bit of an uncomfortable bobble there by the goalie Monahan. It's now pinned back behind his own net as the Ice Lions looking to generate something offensively. We're going to have another hand pass. Thought it was a penalty at first, but we're going to have another face-off inside the defensive zone of the Black Knights as the Ice Lions stick with their Raymundo, Kylie Kneisner line that's played absolutely phenomenal yesterday. Three goals for Sebastian Kylie. Like I said, two coming shorthanded. Definitely looking to bring that, shift that momentum into this game.
It is a big draw here for the second line, Ethan.
Zach Good keeps the puck in at the blue line, sending it all the way down for Kylie. He's got two Black Knights defending him as he moves back and forth, trying to keep that puck in the far corner. Raymundo lays the body there on the far side, and then a battle of puck continues along the Army's bench. Kneisner with the forecheck down below the net of Monahan, and a couple of battles in the far corner, now set up for Goody at the top of the slot. His shot saved by Monahan. Now that puck squirts back into the far corner. Dark Knights pinned back defensively, and now they look to go the other way with numbers. Now hard on the puck as Henry Miller gains the offensive line, but takes a break and looks for their defensive partner just to win a shot there. And a good block there by Seafarth. Kryan lets him hear that one.
Right off the pad there too, Ethan. He read that really well. And right there too, off the blocker. Two back-to-back saves for Seafarth to start the night.
Seafarth looking to get as many shots as he possibly can here early. As he didn't play in yesterday's game, a fantastic effort by John Ferry picking up the shutout up against the Denison Big Red, who it looked like they played a really tough game, showed that the score definitely didn't reflect it, but now Army trying to catch the Ice Lions on a late change there out of the defensive zone. But like I was saying, Matt, Denison with a really hard-fought game against the Ice Lions, definitely not proving to put a ton of, like, you know, just wearing down the Ice Lions as Monahan saves the shot by Carson Cabrell Downs to force a faceoff to his right. But as I was saying, Denison, they played the Ice Lions really hard yesterday despite not even scoring a single goal. The Ice Lions look good and fresh coming out of the game here this weekend.
No, yeah, 100%. Ed. I mean, we mentioned it earlier, just can't be flying this game. And right now, I mean, both teams, I mean, right now the Ice Lions have had more opportunities to start this game. And we also, I failed to mention that earlier when we were talking to Coach in the pregame. He did say get pucks in deep, but he did say, you know, they got to be the aggressors here in this game. A team like Army will give it back to them if they're not showing that forward. So Right now, four shots to one to start off. It's been all Penn State, and let's see if they can keep this pace.
Face off dropped right to the right of the goalie Monahan for the Black Knights. Cabrell Downs now sending it back to the top for the captain, Nathaniel Schumann. He's Clapper just whiffed on that one. Now trying to go the other way. All the Black Knights with Schumann out of position. Cabrell Downs now with the support. He takes a high stick, and that's going to be an early penalty. Power play coming up for the Ice Lions. Able to maintain possession of the puck there is Evan MacDonald creeping in from the neutral zone, now maintaining possession in the offensive zone. On the backhand, just sends it all the way around the boards. Not controlling it on the far side is Nathaniel Schumann. Tries to throw the puck on net. Now Army will touch up, and the first power play of the game goes to the Ice Lions.
And, I mean, Ethan, the Black Knights there had a few numbers going on that offensive rush that they had coming up, and, I mean, Cabrell Downs is just trying to skate away from that player, and, I mean, too aggressive there early on with this stick, and here's a big opportunity here for the Ice Lions to start this lead here, if they can get a lead going here for this early power play opportunity.
The penalty was assessed to number 6 for the Black Knights. That's high home. 2 minutes for high sticking in the first period, and the Black Knights will be a man down here with 12 minutes and 15 seconds to go in the opening frame. Controlling the puck behind the net of Seafarth. Look at a quarterback. This power play is the captain, Nathaniel Schumann. Little saucer pass to Marvis as he goes back and forth with Meyer trying to set things up here on the power play for the Ice Lions. Little backwards pass out of the zone now, and the Lions will try yet again with a minute and 30 remaining on this power play. They have Marvis, Schumann, Kylie, Partridge, and Meyer on the first power play group for Penn State. Controlling it now on the near side is Schumann, sending it all the way across the ice for Meyer. Chips it back, and now the Ice Lions have offensive zone time just for a moment, but it's quickly taken away, and now the puck goes the length of the ice to control it. The other length is Seafarth.
I mean, Ethan, right now, Army has been killing it on this penalty kill. Any opportunity they have when they touch the puck, they're just sending it straight down. No need to move around, waste some time. They're just trying to touch it as quick as they can and just throw it down.
Second power play unit now out there for the Ice Lions is Alec Connolly now is the center for that line. Army sending it down the length of the ice. Really forechecking hard here on the penalty kill. 40 seconds remaining on the man advantage for the Ice Lions. Taking the puck now in the offensive zone is Evan MacDonald. He whips the puck all the way around, and to chase it on the near side is Christian Short. Taking a tumble now in the near corner, and the Black Knights will get another opportunity to send the puck all the way down to Seafarth's end. 20 seconds remaining on the penalty, assessed to Kai Holm.
Seafarth needs to read that pass there. He just left it back there. The Army player was just able to pick that up. Thank God there was no one down low with him.
Christian Short takes a little tumble on the far side. Now Alec Connolly will possess it in the offensive zone with the dying seconds on the power play. Raymundo across the ice looking for an open stick, unable to find one. And a slap shot on the far side is stopped by Monahan with 1 second showing on the penalty to Kai Holm.
I mean, Ethan, not a lot generated there offensively for the Ice Lions. They had a few opportunities there, especially late on with that last shot. But that penalty kill, or what it's been so far, it's been all Army so far. I mean, I just mentioned not too long ago, anytime they touch the puck, they're just trying to get rid of it. What you're supposed to do on this penalty kill is they played it so good, and they even forechecked a little bit. And that's what their coach wants to see. That's how you win these games.
We have another faceoff to the right of Monahan. As the Ice Lions will send out their powerful fourth line that's been really dominant so far this past weekend, especially in the 8-0 victory yesterday against Denison. Now attacking is the forward group for the Black Knights. It's the Delia, Kaiser, and Miller line out there. Teams back at even strength. Shots on goal are 7-5 in favor of Army. Exactly 10 minutes to go now in the first period as both teams are getting used to each other and trying to figure out each other's offensive and defensive schemes. Now good defending. Ice Lions throws a big hit on the far side, unable to knock down the forward there, David Cadigan, for Army. Now a battle for the puck on the near side as Army looks to have all the momentum so far coming out of this penalty kill, Matt.
As Kyle Lawrence just lost his stick, I believe one of the Ice Line players did slap it out of his hand, but they got away with no call there. That's big. There is a massive hit, Ethan. I was about to just mention, we just saw a hit earlier on the boards there. We just got two on that shift here for the Ice Lions. They're throwing him out.
Team's getting physical here into the second half of this first period. Xander Faust avoids a massive hit on the far side there for the Ice Lions. Looked really dangerous, but happy that he's up and skating at his own power. Now on the far side, controlling the puck is Ethan Szymanski, with Xander Faust to his right, unable to get the puck to him. And now retreating is Evan MacDonald. Got to be careful there for Coach Cunningham to not get too many men on the ice. And now Ethan Szymanski with an opportunity the other way. He throws a slapper on that good right pad save there by the goalie Monahan. Now taking it the other way, gaining possession of the offensive zone is Macker. Puck now in the far corner. Looking to retrieve it is Matthew Knysner. That line out there with Raymundo, as long as Sebastian Kiely, the 20 line as I like to call it, as all the players have the number 20 in their number. Sebastian Kiely with some good forechecking there in the neutral zone, but Army's able to throw the puck all the way behind the net of Seafar as they look to set up here. Both teams with not a ton of offensive opportunities so far, but I'm sure that'll change as this looks to be a really defensive matchup so far.
As there's another big save there by Seafarth. Has to be alert on that one, Ethan.
Oh, yeah. Puck is now, they're playing ping pong at Pagula, as I like to say it. Both teams going back and forth, trying to, you know, like I said, trying to figure each other out, try and find the holes in the defense. Andrew Ford looks to be creeping out on that far side. Got to watch and keep an eye out for him, as him and Christian Short are pairing up tonight. Short playing defense with Andrew Fort. Pretty good guys off the ice. They talk a lot and communicate with each other, so gotta have that chemistry on and off the ice.
Hey, Ethan, how great teams win in hockey is just having a tight bond with your group. Anytime you can have, you know, that personal level with your teammates on and off the ice, it just makes your group even tighter. And that's what these Ice Lions look to have this year. As I mean, they already have two wins to their name, and let's see if they can start building it and hopefully get more chemistry as this season goes on.
Looking to add on their two-game win streak, the Ice Lions, that is, against Army this weekend. We saw that the Lady Lions previously on this game had a season sweep against the University of Rhode Island Rams. That was the game that was just on previously as Alec Connolly throws a wrister, just went high in the net. Connolly now behind the net trying to make a couple of moves against Army, and now Christian Short will settle at the top of the key, throws it on net, unable to find Monahan, and now a backhand second attempt by Alec Connolly just went wide.
Big opportunity there by Alec Connolly. Just couldn't find a pad or anything, or even towards the net. Just went wide.
Army now putting some pressure on the Ice Lions as they have a tired group out there. Sending it all the way down. Referee has his hand up, but not even close to the goal line as that puck waves off the icing. Army looking to retreat now, trying to get out of the defensive zone as they send the puck the length of the ice, and now touching up is Alex Marvis for an icing.
They tried to find, I believe that was the big man there in Michael Fremgen. So, I mean, just missed that cross ice pass and just unfortunately it's an icing for the Black Knights, but it's a big opportunity here for the Ice Lions getting an offensive zone here. Offensive draw, so.
Top forward group out there for the Ice Lions, consisting of Velarde, Partridge, and Meyer. Velarde with two goals in yesterday's game, almost at a hat trick. Wasn't able to stuff in that last attempt at towards the end of the third period. He had a beautiful tic-tac-toe goal assisted by Partridge and Meyer in that game. You guys missed out on that one. Make sure you get tuned into that stream after this one. Meyer now gains offensive zone time for the Ice Lions, trying to throw it on net. That saucer pass just went wide in the far corner.
Look for a deflection there, Ethan.
Army looking to go the other way, just dumping it in and getting those tired groups of guys out there. Top line for the Ice Lions looking really strong so far as Meyer now is unable to control the puck on the near side right in front of the broadcasting booth. Partridge and Velarde now hard on the puck on the near side as Army looks to regroup defensively. Hard on the puck now is Brendan Connor, one of the milkmen that I was alluding to earlier in the first period, and his stick goes flying across the ice on the far side. Gotta hold on to your stick there.
I think you need that there, Ethan.
Alec Riggle now takes a tumble. Now Army yet again will try and clear the zone as Macker makes a great play on the near boards, walking in with a shot save there by Monahan with the right pad.
Juicy rebounds coming out here for the Ice Lions. They have someone there home in the slot. He's going to try to bury one of those home.
Now putting pressure on as this fourth line that I kept talking about so highly of this past weekend in that win against Denison. They had three goals all coming from Sebastian Kiely.
That goes to show you too, Ethan. I mean, doesn't matter which year of your lines is your strongest. I mean, if you're gonna have a very strong fourth line, you can win hockey games. That's how you build depth for your teams, and you know, get late wins late on. And you know, it doesn't have to be your first line players to be your heroes.
An opportunity there for the Black Knights. Clark Wagner was unable to get that puck. Great defensive play by Evan MacDonald to hold the Black Knights to no offensive opportunities there. Xander Faust without the stick tries to kick it with his skates in the far corner, but taking it away quickly was Army. We're going to go the other way with the puck is Caleb Kaiser, but he gets the puck taken away from Xander Faust, who had retrieved his stick just a minute ago. West Point looking to generate something offensively, but it looks like it's all Ice Lions right now as they've had the majority of the offensive pressure so far in this first period, 4 minutes to go in this first frame. Shots are 9-7 in favor of Army. And I expected a very defensive matchup, but it looks like we're getting that so far, Matt.
Yeah, a lot of physicality right now in front of us. I mean, a lot of hits being thrown. We're seeing right now Army players are losing their sticks left and right because of how physical this game has been so far. Right there, right in front of us, number 23 for the Ice Lions just went down, so.
Sending it the length of the ice all the way around the boards is Christian Short, intended for Sebastian Kylie, and he receives the puck in the far corner. Kylie now for Raymundo. He throws a backhander right in front. Where's the puck? No one can find it, and it's finally cleared by Army.
Oh, man, what an opportunity there by the Ice Lions.
Turnover there by Alex Mavris in the slot. Now an opportunity for Army in the dying couple minutes of the first period. Both teams trying to get on the scoreboard here and adjust to each other. Liam Egan now, the hitman travel man, trying to gain offensive possession time, and unable to do so as the puck was taken away from him in the neutral ice.
What a play earlier in their defensive zone by MJ Otranda. I mean, on that turnover, he stayed with that forward for Army and, you know, tracked him all the way to the corner. Didn't even give him any room to even get a pass out there, Ethan.
Egan now in the near corner, trying to possess it for the Ice Lions, trying to get something going offensively, and Egan just has a flutter shot and an easy stop there by the goalie, Liam Monahan.
Monahan and Seifert, I mean, they've had a lot of shots so far to test him, but they both look really solid in this game, especially for Seifert starting in his first match of the season. So, I mean, that's what both teams want. They want their goalies to, you know, keep them in there in this game as close as they can. And who will break this deadlock first? I mean, we've had a lot of shots so far to start this game.
Yeah, the first goal is going to be really important as both teams try to get some sort of momentum going towards the end of the first intermission. A big collision towards that icing, both teams trying to race to the end of that puck, and Alex Mavris was able to beat them to that one. And the Ice Lions get the opportunity to get the change here.
I believe it was Otrando beating out Aronov, as Aronov also threw a hit on him after that whistle blew. I mean, and looking back at how big this Army team is, Ethan, I mean, even their first line guys, I mean, look how big these kids are.
Oh, yeah. They're massive. Easily the biggest group that I've seen so far coming from Blue. And I mean, Brendan Myers is getting absolutely toppled up against his wing partner, up against on the other side, Mark Lehman. The slap shot saved there by Monahan. There's a rebound. Where's the puck? Referees blow the whistle. And some pushing and shoving occur after the end of that one. Grade A chance there by Schumann as he rips one from the top of the blue line.
Brendan Myers took a shot there to the back after the whistle. I mean, we're going to see this. I mean, it's going to be a chippy game now. I mean, we've seen the physicality. So for the viewers back at home, after these whistles, I mean, don't. You're going to see these players go at each other. I mean, they've already shown that the physicality is going to be one on this ice.
I know this is your first game for the Ice Lions calling the game, but it feels like every time there's a physical match between the Ice Lions and their opponent, Brendan Byer just takes the grunt of the injury. Not really sure why, but don't know why he's an easy target for opposing teams, but he really is just able to take it so well and able to chirp back. I know he's got a couple chirps in his back pocket.
I mean, where was he then when he took those hits, Ethan? Right in front of the net where he's supposed to be.
Absolutely. He's a hard worker and just always crashing the net looking for opportunities to put his team up front. Brendan Meyer, great skilled player, and in his senior season just looking to imprint his name in this Ice Lions dynasty. Sending the puck the length of the ice is Evan MacDonald. Referee blows the whistle and negates the icing there. Great extra effort by Ethan Szymanski. Rather, that was Joey Velarde. Velarde, Szymanski, Short, Fort, and Riggle now out there. A bunch of combinations of different lines as Cunningham will try and get their normal groups out there. Not sure if he's changing up the lines, but Velarde will now head to the bench and to replace him is Xander Faust. Minute and 15 to go here in the first period. Deadlocked at zero. Deadlocked on shots on goal. What's better than this? Alec Riggle, rather, taken down in the far corner. Referee keeps their hand down. No call. Black Knights are able to take the puck out of their defensive zone and try and create something here towards the end of the first period. Just 1 minute to go here in this opening frame. Battle for the puck in the far corner as Andrew Fort was backing down a defender. And the Ice Lions are able to control the puck in their defensive zone. Just under a minute to go here in the first period.
And Ethan, you know, usually in these games, especially for teams that don't play each other, there's usually a feeling out process in these hockey games. Well, while we've had a little bit of that, these teams have just gone all out so far. They're not afraid to, you know, introduce each other to themselves.
Definitely. And like I said, Matt, this first goal is going to be extremely important for not for either team, whoever is able to get it, because it's going to really set the tone and really make the other team hungry to try and fight back. So you got to be really careful, especially if you're the ice lines, if you get that first goal, to be not to just be chipping back and forth with Army. Now with 10 seconds remaining, both teams trying to get something going before the end of the period, and Matthew Knysna unable to get a shot there as his stick was tied up with a Black Knight defender. Clock strikes zero, and that'll be the end of the first period. As we send you back ringside, Ethan Zaretsky joined alongside Matt Cabram. A great first period, exactly what I was expecting so far in this game between two really strong defensive teams, Matt. What's going to be the key going into the second period for both of these teams?
Well, Ethan, I mean, you just touched on it. I mean, defense, and physicality was the story of this first, and both teams did not stray to be away from that defensive zone. But, I mean, it's both teams really trying to find their offensive schemes is what both teams are going to try to look for in their second periods. I mean, I think both coaches are going to talk in the locker room right now. They're going to love the defense. But, I mean, one of these offensive schemes got to at least crack a defense soon, and that's what they're going to look for. I mean, more shots on net, more shots towards the goal, and, I mean, who's going to score first? I mean, you just said it. First goal is really going to be the storyteller of this game.
Exactly, Matt. At the end of the first period, teams deadlocked at zero. We will see you for the second period shortly. Welcome back to Papula Ice Arena. My name is Ethan Zarensky. Joining alongside me is my color commentator, Mac Abram, and we are set to start the second period of play between the Penn State Ice Lions and the Army Black Knight. Matt, what an interesting first period that we saw, a very defensive battle to start this game. As we expected, not a ton of goals are going to be coming by in this one, so the first one's going to be really important.
And Ethan, we've been screaming defense this entire broadcast, but now really, which coach is really trying to implement it into their teams to adjust to this defensive structures? Who will break the ice here? I mean, 9-9 on shots. It was 0-0 game, deadlock everywhere. Something's going to have to give soon.
Ice Lions going from right to left as we see them. The Army Black Knights going from left to right, opposite of what it was in the first period. Like you just said, Matt, shots are 9 apiece. Score is 0-0 to start this second period. Wasn't able to get a chance to speak to either coaches during the intermission, but got to assume you just got to stick to your own game plan and see and try and get the first goal of this one. As Army is going to ice his puck to start the second period. No adjustments so far in the lineups for either team. Ice Lions started the second period with their second line. Exactly what they did in the first period. Now with their top line out there, Partridge, Velarde, and Brendan Meyer, they look to set up now offensively. Fort with a shot, unable to get to the net of Monahan. Steered to the right of him. 1 minute played in this second period. Puck is now battled for in the near corner to the left of the broadcasting booth as Army is pinned back in their defensive zone. Unable to keep the puck in there was Christian Short. Now 2-on-1 developing for Army the other way. An opportunity to take the lead. Great chance there by the Army was taken away by Andrew Fort. We saw his sliding plays and the way that he's able to get his stick in the lane was very predominant in yesterday's victory against Denison, stopping a ton of 2-on-1 opportunities. Shout out to Andrew Fort for putting his body on the line for his team.
I mean, yeah, that was a big opportunity by the Black Knights there, Ethan, as, I mean, 2-on-1 using 9 times out of 10, it's bread and butter for teams like that.
Yep.
Not for the Ice Lions. Great defensive play there by Andrew Fort, throwing the stick up, and also not taking the high-sticking whistle, too. So pretty big there by the Ice Lions, as that kind of helps Seaver settle in, knowing that he had a 2-on-1. If you're a goalie, you see a 2-on-1, you get a little nervous. You got to make sure that you let them make the move and not let them break you. So yep. big play there by Andrew Fort on defense there to help out his goalie and Seaver.
Charlie Aronov was the forward there on the 2-on-1 that tried to get a saucer pass over to his line mate. That was Ben Gosher. Unable to get that pass across due to the great sliding play of Andrew Fort, like we were just talking about. Referee signaled down a whistle. 1:58 played here in this first period. Both teams have one shot on goal to start the second period as Army's able to win the faceoff defensively and they look to go the other way. Zach Good now defensively, he takes a tumble and now Army has a chance and they weren't able to get a shot on net there. The puck was steered wide by Seafarth. Now an opportunity for West Point as they had a chance there in the slot, unable to get a shot off on Seafarth, trying to test him as much as possible. West Point unable to keep the zone and Goody will now retreat for the Ice Lions behind the net of Seafarth. He's able to clear the puck out of the zone. Puck was tipped, intended for Alec Connolly, unable to grab on his stick.
Yeah, big play there, Ethan. I mean, oh, and we're going to get an icing here going against the Black Knights. And the Ice Lions again, Ethan. I mean, both teams have been very consistent on these faceoffs. Both teams haven't really drawn off a play off of a faceoff like this. So let's see if the Ice Lions can at least get something drawn up here for this.
Last season, Matt, you weren't with the Ice Lions program, but they really did very well in the second period, scoring primarily all their goals in the second and third period. So Ice Lions looking to adjust a little bit and play their game in the second and the third period as they look to get the first tally of the game with their bottom line, who has been so amazing this weekend, featuring Xander Faust, Alec Riggle, and Ethan Szymanski. Had a chance to talk to Szymanski after the game. He was chatting up with his parents outside the rink, always the first one out of the locker room. He must not like his equipment very much as he tries to get it off as fast as possible, but Szymanski, he was very proud of the way he played yesterday. As a freshman on the Ice Lions team like this, surrounded by a bunch of veterans such as Schumann and Connolly and Brendan Meyer, like you're just trying to get your name known. Like Evan Partridge He's doing a fantastic job offensively on that top group with Meyer and another freshman, Joey Velarde. So all these freshmen on the ice line just trying to get acclimated. Szymanski now with Faust trying to get a shot off there. He's unable to do so. Schumann now with a backhand puck in the slot and quickly taken away by the Black Knights.
As there was a quick desperation move there by Nate Schumann there. He just tried to get it towards the net.
Great takeaway there by Kai Holm, who has the only penalty in this contest. Power play went to the Ice Lions early in the first period, but the Black Knights did a really good job defensively on the penalty kill to negate any opportunity that the Ice Lions wanted to try and get a goal.
And Ethan, we're not even done yet with this feeling out process. I mean, almost 4 minutes to play in this period. Both teams only with a shot. I mean, they're still bringing this physicality and not really giving any other team that open chance to, you know, find a shot in the slot or, you know, that open, you know, shot to the net, getting pucks in deep, so.
Yeah, like I said, I mean, my favorite reference at Pegula is they're playing ping pong because teams play back and forth, especially the Ice Lions in the first couple periods. They like to play back and forth with teams, trying to figure everything out, and then, like we saw yesterday in the Denison game, they only had a few goals in the first period, but then really opened it up in the second and the third, totaling to 8 goals at the end of that one. Now Raymundo gains the line with an opportunity. Raymundo with his shot just went wide. Got to get those shots on net if you're Raymundo. He had a fantastic freshman season for the Ice Lions last year, but now in his sophomore year, he's got a couple of goals on the season. He's looking to gel himself in that lineup. Looks very comfortable in the locker room compared to his freshman season.
Yeah, Raymundo had a toe drag shot there, but just like you said, you got to get it on net. I mean, anything right now could be that game-changing shot against these goalies in Monahan and in Seaforth.
Only one shot for each team 5 minutes into the second period. We saw 9 for each team at the end of the first. Knysner's able to win that puck battle on the near side and send it all the way down behind Monahan. Controlling the puck now for the Black Knights is defenseman number 20, Magnus Sheridan.
You're good, my bad.
I was just going to say that Austin Lambert is in the lineup, didn't play in yesterday's game. He was in the PA box controlling all the sounds and systems and such. And now he is skating as the 7th defenseman for the Ice Lions today. Now he is tested with a 2-on-1 opportunity, which was quickly taken away. Great play there by Alex Mavris. And now an opportunity for the Black Knights quickly generated there by their top line. Great defensive play by the Ice Lions to keep it a 0-0 game. Referee signals for a hand pass.
And a big smart play there by Joey Velarde to get into his defensive zone and clean that puck up for his goalie in Seaforth. I mean, not a lot of forwards in a situation like that will quickly head to the net, but a smart forward does. And I mean, and going back to your point earlier where you said this team is, at the second period, is there a scoring period? Great teams can win hockey games, Ethan, but good teams win hockey games, but great teams adjust during the periods and during intermissions. And how will these teams adjust in this game right now so far in a 12 to 10 shots, 0-0? We played some, you know, a few minutes here in the second period and just, you know, nothing has shown yet besides a few of these chances here by the Black Knights.
And that's why we bring you on the broadcast, Matt. Great analysis there as both teams are still trying to feel each other out, but we're still feeling each other out, really trying to get to know each other, and you know, one's trying to find the open spots and try and get that first opening goal. That's really going to give them some momentum towards the game. It looks like this first goal is going to be really critical on how the rest of this game folds out.
I mean, I think they already know each other so well, Ethan. I mean, all this physicality, these players have been so up on each other and, you know, bringing that force. I mean, right there, we just saw a big hit right there going into the Ice Lions offensive opportunity zone.
Egan there with a big opportunity was shut down by the left pad of Monahan. Egan took a big hit after the end of that one, looking for a call, not going to get one. Egan now in the far corner, battling against two Black Knights, unable to get the puck in the slot. And now the Black Knights take the puck out of their defensive zone. Hard on it now is Charlie Aronov, who had a grade A 2-on-1 earlier in the first period, who was quickly negated by Andrew Ford. Now a chance for the Black Knights as they generate something on offense. A backhander there on Seaforth. The puck was loose for a second, but the Ice Lions were able to clear the zone. Now these teams are looking to open up a little bit as chances on both ends open up. Broadcaster's curse coming a little bit here in the second period at Pegula Ice Arena in State College, Pennsylvania.
That was a big play by, I believe it was, my apologies, I think it was Austin Lambert, who cleared it out. I mean, another play. I mean, long shift, and you still got to give it all out for your team to make sure, I mean, keep this game 0-0 and help out your goalie any way you can to clear that puck out of the zone for him.
As the guys call him in the locker room, Lambo, Austin Lambert, huffing and puffing on the bench as he just almost had a minute and a half shift Great play there by Lambert, trying to generate something on offense for his team. Going the other way is Nathaniel Schumann and company as they try and generate something after Black Knights almost had a goal there at the end of that last shift. Szymanski now looking, waiting for his players to touch up, but then quickly taken away by the Black Knights and they look to go the other way. Now taken away by the captain Schumann and now a 2-on-1 developing for the Ice Lions. Riggle with Szymanski on his right, shot by Riggle, and he scores! Alec Riggle breaks the deadlock and it's 1-0 Ice Lions!
What a goal by Riggle here, Ethan. I mean, he had the 2-on-1, and guess what? He's going to hold it, and guess what? He's going to stick it. 1-0, the Ice Lions lead, as this place is roaring here. You got a good crowd behind us.
Riggle throws the puck on net, just went underneath the pads of the goalie Monahan, and just like that, a quick 2-on-1 for Riggle, and Szymanski takes the lead for the Ice Lions, and now we have a brand new game here at Pegula.
And just like I mentioned too, Riggle could have passed along to his teammate, and guess what? He saw that 5-hole and he sticks it in. Big, big, big goal here by Riggle, and this could be a goal that could really change the momentum of this game, Ethan. I mean, the Ice Lions have come out in the second period, and they look sharp, so... Yeah. That was the end of the breakdown. Honestly, I mean, they look sharp, and I mean, they get the goal here to start off, and they've looked really good here.
I guess this line's making you speechless. They played so well in yesterday's game. Now they're finally able to add on to the score sheet. Now Knysler with a shot. Great save there with the right pad of Monahan. That goal was scored exactly 8 minutes into the second period. It's Riggle unassisted. What a shot there by Alec Riggle. And now the Ice Lions take the 1-0 lead here in the second period. Shot on by Christian Short, unable to find the net there. And he's able to keep the puck in now on the far side.
Ice Lions goal scored on number 7, Alec Riggle.
And Ethan, that's 4 goals by the fourth line in 2 games. I mean, we mentioned it earlier, in this game of hockey, doesn't matter which line you're on, if you can produce and you can score, by all means, please score. I mean,
Ethan Szymanski was credited with the assist on that goal. My apologies, thought it was unassisted, but Szymanski getting his name on the score sheet for the first time this weekend. Great play by him to set up that 2-on-1 opportunity.
Big 2 points there by the fourth line of the Ice Lions.
Yep, that line is just really becoming very predominant in their play. Just trying to get the gel going, but now on the far side, Sebastian Kiley with a shot, right off the post. Goody with another opportunity, just sends the puck wide to the far side. Kiley to retrieve that one. At the puck, a shot by Mavris, unable to find the net. Ice Lions buzzing here towards the first half of the second period. Knysler now hard on the puck behind the net, and Monahan takes down a Black Knight. Now they still have the puck. Knysler with a shot, unable to get another rebound. Kiley looking across the ice, and now a stick is through the skates of Sebastian Kiley. Don't see that too often. Now he battles a couple Black Knights behind their own net. Puck now on the near side, trying to clear it out of the zone. Are the Black Knights? They're finally able to do so. No icing on the play. Alex Mavris now with the puck in the defensive zone for the Ice Lions, sends it all the way up to Brendan Meyer. Teams look very comfortable now as Partridge tries to throw the puck out front, unable to find another stick. Partridge now maintaining possession of the puck in the far corner. Partridge looking for Schumann. Schumann with a shot, unable to get the net of Monahan. Now another opportunity, unable to get a stick as the delayed penalty on the ice, I believe. Not sure if that's an icing. It is an icing. No interference is going to be called on the Ice Lions. I'm not sure what the referee is signaling here. But there's going to be a penalty on Joey Berardi, and the Black Knights will have their first opportunity, a man up, to try and equalize this game at 1.
And just like this, Ethan, the tides can turn. I mean, already 1-0, the Ice Lions lead, and boom, they hit a post there, and then just like right here right in front of us, I believe Nate Schumann also grades the post on his shot. So 2 post shots for the Ice Lions. They could have made this a 2-0, 3-0 game, and guess what? We still got a 1-0 game, and now the Black Knights will head to their first power play of the game. Could really change the tides of this game.
Ice Lions now shorthanded for the first time this game. Wanted to apologize for calling number 17, Evan MacDonald. Gonna be honest, as a broadcaster, trying to communicate with Coach Cunningham before the game, not 100% sure the defender, but I'm gonna take an educated guess and say that that's Ryan Cleary on defense for the Ice Lions, playing with Nathaniel Schumann. Evan MacDonald played defense last year, number 14 for the Ice Lions, and he's on the roster as number 14, but having a little bit of jersey issues so far in the beginning of the season are the Ice Lions. because just trying to get everyone on the same page is a little bit difficult, but bear with me as I'm doing my best to try and get everyone's names correct. Referees discussing where this faceoff should be dropped as teams converge to center ice.
And this is the right call, Ethan. I mean, the Ice Lions did draw the penalty, but the Black Knights also iced it, so this is a fair faceoff here in the neutral zone.
All right, center ice. 9:56 remaining in the second period. Black Knights on their first power play of the game is going to generate something offensively, and Schumann lays the hammer. What a big hit by Schumann on the near side, sending down Clark Wagner on his butt. Now the Black Knights have an opportunity here offensively on the power play.
What a hit, Ethan. I mean, that shook the whole arena here.
Yeah, the fans definitely loved that one, cheering behind us to our left. Aronov now passing it up for Wagner. Controlling the puck now for the Black Knights on this power play. Aronov now with the puck on the near side. Circling back, looking for an option as he surveys his options. Now at the top of the key, big slap shot there. Can't miss him. It's Mark Lehman at the top of the key, quarterbacking this power play. Aronov now back on the near side. Aronov now back at the top of the key. Walks in, he shoots, big block by Meyer, and he clears. What a big on four battle there, and the white four got advantage there.
And you've also mentioned too, I mean, Brendan Meyer, one of these hard grindstone to the nose players. I mean, he all gave his body on the line there and even, you know, cleared it out. So big play there by Brendan Meyer to, you know, help his team out on this penalty kill.
Can't stress that enough. Sebastian Kiley on the penalty kill for the Ice Lions, being an aggressive forechecker as he had two shorthanded goals yesterday. Easily the best shorthanded attacker for the Ice Lions so far this season, as he pickpockets at Black Knight in the middle of the ice and creates a turnover just for a moment there, but now looking to step back up is Aronov and company. Sebastian Kiley hard on the puck, as well as Matthew Knizner, trying to get the puck away from the Black Knights as their tired group with 18 seconds left trying to generate something on offense. Puck is whistled down, I believe it's for a hand pass, and there's gonna be a faceoff right outside the zone. Great penalty kill so far for the Ice Lions, Matt.
I mean, it was a very different penalty kill from the Army Black Knights. I mean, the Black Knights, every time they touch the puck, they do it down. This is the Ice Lions. They're probably having a little fun with it, Ethan. I mean, they're skating it around, and just like you said too, in I believe you mentioned it was Sebastian Kiley. I mean, one of the best shorthanded killers on this team. So I mean, anytime he can, you know, get an opportunity to skate the puck out a little bit, I mean, he's done this before, so he's chilling.
Team's back at even strength. Back to the bench is Joey Velarde, and now both teams with defensive stoppages on the power play for each team. Score still 1-0 in favor of the Ice Lions. Just under 8 minutes to play here in the middle frame. Black Knights looking very hungry, looking for this equalizing goal. Tie this game up. Collision in the front of the net, trying to draw a penalty there. Were the Black Knights, Alec Wiggle not having any of that. A lone goal scorer in this game now. Xander Faust with an opportunity here. Quickly taken away. Great defensive play there by Drake Ott. Alec Wiggle now with the puck in the far corner as he's slammed up against the boards by Anthony Chambers. Settling the puck in the offensive zone. Arlie Ice Lions just for a moment, but now Lambeau and Goody will retreat. Black Knights, like I just said, are looking very hungry for this equalizing goal, because if the Ice Lions were to go up two, it'd be very difficult for them to come back. The lone forechecker for the Black Knights, now an opportunity for them. Walking in the slot, shot on, was deflected right before it got to the slot. Puck skimpers out in the defensive zone of the Black Knights, and they'll look to retreat. Defensively controlling the puck is Wyatt Symmachus. His father, I just saw him during the intermission, came all the way out here from St. Louis, Missouri, so you gotta love that dedication coming from the Symmachus family. Shout out to you if you're listening from home.
Ethan, it doesn't matter what level you play. If you're playing college sport, your parents are gonna come out and support you. So, love to see that they're coming all the way from St. Louis, and you know, just grows the game. I mean, just like you mentioned earlier, we have listeners over in Australia, the land down under, so that's what you love to see.
Yeah, shout out to the Mavericks family and friends from Australia who just gave very good compliments to the broadcast right before we started here today. So we appreciate the support. That's why we do it here. Gotta just love being a part of the Penn State broadcasts. And another big shout out to the Seafarm family for giving us a tripod. Mr. Seafarm saw that we were having some issues with our tripod there on the bleachers, but he was able to think of us and bring a new tripod. Great block there by Carson Cabrell Downs off the shot at the top of the key. by Magnus Sheridan. But like I was just saying, shout out to Mr. Seafarth giving us that tripod and having the best experience that we could possibly have for the viewers.
And Ethan, you know what that means, right? The Ice Lions officially have the best fans in all of the ACHA.
Oh, yeah. I mean, Ben Wasserman loves to talk about that, but Ice Lions just love to give us a ton of support in and out. And then big save there by Seafarth, as we were just talking about. His father taken down in the far corner was Cabral Downs. Ice Lions on the bench wanted a penalty there, but backed up in their defensive zone. The Ice Lions trying to retreat out. And a big hit by Liam Egan right in front of the broadcasting booth. Egan with those hit men, blue gloves, can't miss him throwing the body in every angle he possibly can. Now going in the near corner is Egan. Egan, Cabral, Downs, and Connolly out there now for the Ice Lions. Lambert at the end of a long shift, paired up with Nathaniel Schumann, and Lambert will retreat back to the bench. Cabral Downs tries to make a couple moves around to Black Knight in the neutral zone, but not having any of that, and Seafarth will just glove it down to Schumann, and they look to regroup defensively. Sending the puck the length of the ice, unable to retreat it on the near boards with Anthony Chambers, and the referee whistles down for an icing. 5 minutes to go in the second period. Penn State Ice Lions up against Army Black Knights. We thank all of you for tuning into today's broadcast. These two are going to be facing off tomorrow in the second game of their series, so you definitely do not want to miss how that one's going to end. After this one, Joey Velarde will drop it for Brendan Meyer as the Ice Lions look to set up offensively, trying to get that extra tally to put them up too. Now a puck thrown on net. Brendan Meyer, the rebound's there, but then it was quickly taken away by Monahan.
As there we go again, Ethan. Brendan Meyer taking some shots after the whistle right in front of the net. But that's where he wants to be. I mean, it was Meyer coming off the side of Velarde. Velarde tried to find the tip of Meyer. Then once they were able to glove it down and throw it towards the net, Meyer's there again. So definitely likes to be in front of the net, trying to look for those open, juicy rebounds. So obviously help his team go up two goals. It'd be pretty big for them.
Puck was dropped to the left of Monahan, and a chance there for Velarde, unable to get a clean shot off there as the puck just went over his stick. Covered there by Monahan yet again, and we're going to have a face-off from his right now, opposite side of where it just was. 14:33 remaining in the second period. Shots on goal at 16 apiece. Face-off won there by Partridge, and now Schumann will control it with Cleary. Cleary with a shot saved by Monahan, no rebound. Schumann now unable to control the zone, and he'll head back to help Ryan Cleary. Schumann tries to level a Black Knight into his own bench. Great evasive play there by the Black Knights forward. Clearing the zone are the Ice Lions with 4 minutes and change to go here in the second period.
As they get some fresh legs out on the ice, even they had a little bit of an extended shift there.
Trying to complete that full line change. Raymundo's out there with two forwards from the top line. Now the Black Knights go the other way. With an opportunity here is James DeLeo one-on-one with Andrew Fort. Backtracking is Ryan Cleary, and the great chance there was taken away by Andrew Fort. It's been all over the ice defensively for the Ice Lions. Can't forget that. Great chance there, sent across the crease there by DeLeo, unable to find another Black Knight stick. Puck is now behind the net of Seafarth, now taken down behind the net. Was a Black Knights forward. Didn't get to see there, but it looked like it was Kyle Lawrence, no call. Andrew Fort now controlling defensively, sending it all the way the length of the ice for Ryan Cleary. Tipped there by Knysner in the neutral ice, negates the icing. Knysner now on a hard forecheck behind the net of Monahan. Stick the poke, and the puck is in front of the slot there for just a moment. Then quickly taken away by the Black Knights. Puck then sent across there behind the net, taken away. Now Lawrence has the puck going the other way. Lawrence will float the puck there. Great blocker save by Seafarth to the far corner. Shot on again by Seafarth, unable to find that one, and is quickly cleared away by the Ice Lions defense.
Hey, Seafarth was unable to find that puck, or at least he was able to locate it with his pads, get it cleared out the way. Unfortunately, I think we'll be going against the Ice Lions there, but hey, Seafarth keeps it out. We still got a 1-0 game, Ethan. Very, very, very tight game, and I mean, the viewers can see it. The hits are flying right now.
Oh yeah, very physical game, like we mentioned. First period, teams getting to try and know each other a little bit more, but then as the second and third period unfold, teams are going to get a little bit more physical, finding those gaps in the forwards and defensive pairs. Now Ice Lions trying to get some numbers going the other way, and they're going to be able to do so. Knysner, Raymundo, and Kylie. Now Raymundo for Kylie, scores! That is Knysner on the rebound! 2-0 Ice Lions!
And if a team even needed a bigger insurance goal, they just got it. The Ice Lions are off and running here, and the second they take the show, it's 2-0.
Great follow-up there by Matthew Knizner. Their first shot was by Raimundo, and cleaning it up on the near side was Knizner. So now a 2-0 advantage for the Ice Lions. They're able to pat on that lead against the Black Knights.
Ethan, what's one of those first rules in hockey that you learned? A player shoots a shot, where do you go?
Go right to the front of the net, keep your stick on the ice, and good things are going to happen. And that just happened for Matthew Knizner. Shout out to the family of Matthew watching from home. We know you guys are always supporting the streams. So we thank you and appreciate your time for that. Now another opportunity for the Ice Lions. Szymanski was unable to get that pass across to Xander Faust. But now Alec Riggle has some other words for the Black Knights as he makes a great stick check, keeping the puck in the zone. Szymanski with a dipsy doodle in the far corner, unable to get a shot on net. Riggle still battling for the puck as his game is extremely improved over the past two seasons. Szymanski takes a hard hit in the slot after trying to get a shot on Monahan, unable to do so. 2 minutes to go here in the second period. Ice Lions had just tallied on another tally to make this a two-goal lead for Penn State.
I mean, what a play by Knizner there, Ethan. I mean, you just said it, hit the hammer on the head with the nail. I mean, hey, you keep your stick down, you go to the net, good things will happen, and boom, the loose change. Knizner, 2-0 Ice Lions.
Puck now in the far corner, controlled there by Henry Miller. Sending it at the top, a shot on, saved there by Seafarth into the netting. And with a minute and 29 seconds to go in the first period, a second period rather, Ice Lions will get a full change on forward and defense.
Ethan, I had a broadcast jinx that I didn't want to bring up, but now it's been happening. I was going to say this whole period flew so by, I feel like we've had no whistles. Now the last 3 minutes I've been trying to say this, we've had about three or four.
Yeah, broadcaster's drinks definitely prevalent in Pagula, no matter what rink we're on. Yesterday we had a couple of those with me and Alex McChrystal, along with Paige Clark as well. I mean, it's unfortunate, but also unfortunate, but the broadcasters, we do our best. As that Eagle, Cabrel Downs, Connolly, and Egan lines out there offensively for the Ice Lions in the remaining minute and change in the second period. Controlling it in the slot now, a weak backhander just missed the net. And Henry Miller was able to get a chance there for the Black Knights as they're desperately looking for a goal to cut the lead in half. Puck is sent the length of the ice, going to be on net of Monahan. He's going to control it and steer it for a defender and then second guess it as Liam Egan.
Hey, risky smart play by the Ice Lions. You don't want the icy puck, but guess what? They threw it all the way down right into the goalie in Monahan. Helps them out. They get their offensive change and they get a fresh pair of skates out there. They get an offensive zone draw, and they got 50 seconds on how to work the clock, Ethan. So, already up two. If you're the Ice Lions, you're shooting pretty, but guess what? You're not letting the foot off the gas at all against this Army team. I mean, we've seen the physicality by both these teams, and you can't let up now. It's still so much clock left in this game.
Faceoff's going to be to the left of Monahan. Faceoff's lost by the Ice Lions, but then possession is regained by Velarde for just a moment as the puck is sent into the Ice Lions bench. We'll have another whistle. Puck's going to be dropped right outside the defensive zone. Rather than move the faceoff right back to where it just was to the left of Monahan. Ice Lions win this faceoff. That's Partridge, who's been playing center very recently for the Ice Lions. Started off as a winger, centered by Alec Connolly, but now centering that top line with Meyer along with Joey Velarde. 30 seconds remain in the second period. Shots on goal are still even at 19 apiece. And I just wanted to give a shout out to Owen Roy and family. I played alongside him. He's part of the Army Black Knights crew, watching from the stands, supporting his team. But just wanted to, you know, point that out I did end up playing high school hockey with Owen Roy. So just a little bit of worlds colliding here. Gotta love to see that. Now 20 seconds remaining in the second period. Both teams looking to clean things up here as we're going to be heading into the third period. It's looking like with a 2-0 lead in favor of the Ice Lions, Matt. What a fantastic game that we've had so far. Second period a little bit different than the first. A lot more offense being generated by the Ice Lions as we see the 2-0 score showing.
And we saw the better team in the second period, Ethan, adjust to what they saw in the first period. Is that what they were able to do? They were able to keep sticks out on the ice. And they were able to, you know, tap home two goals. We have a 2-0 lead for the Ice Lions. They're sitting really good, but guess what? There's still a lot of puck left to go in this game.
As we send you back ringside, Ethan Zaretsky joined alongside me, Matt Cabram. a great second period for the Ice Lions. A little bit deflating for the Army Black Knights, but they're not completely out of this game. Just one goal is going to make the difference.
Yeah, 100%, Ethan. It's still anyone's game. There's still so much clock left in this game. And, you know, how will Army adjust being down 2-0, and can they play being down that two-goal lead?
You see that the Ice Lions are able to play down, but now Army challenged with that fatal task. Stay tuned for the third period. We'll be just back with you very shortly. As we get set for the start of the third period, my name is Ethan Zaretsky, and joined alongside me is my great color commentator, Matt Gabram. I mean, other than Matt, who else would be doing this podcast right now?
Come on, guys. This is my third event of the day, and I'm still so stoked, and we still have 20 minutes of hockey to play here. But Ethan, let's break down that second period.
Penn State Ice Lions with two goals in the second period, a very deadlocked game to that point. No goals in the first period. Very even on shots as we send you to center ice so far for the third period. Both teams get ready for this game in the third period, and we're underway. So like I was saying, Matt, 2-0 lead for the Penn State Ice Lions. Two goals in the second period. What is the big key for Army going into this third period to try and get underneath the Ice Lions' skin and trying to get at least one to cut into the deficit?
I mean, this Army business needs to know that this game is far from over, very far from over. I mean, look at the clock, Ethan, 19:37 on the clock. There's so much time for Army to at least get something going here, at least almost get something close to drawing at least equal with the score. And I mean, Ethan, we've watched hockey our whole lives. I mean, a two-goal lead in hockey is the scariest lead to have.
Oh, absolutely. Unless it's 3-1, 2-0 is easily as hard to come back to, because, I mean, you have no goals on one team. Now, Evan Partridge has another words to say about that. Partridge taking it harder than that, and the referee's hand is up, not sure what he's signaling. I like this. As they're going to get that settled.
And now back to that, the two-goal lead in hockey is the worst lead, because all it takes for Army right now, boom, one shot during this entire 19 minutes, and they're back in this game. So it really will be for both teams, how does Penn State adjust with playing up to, and how will Army, I think I said this before we went to the break, how will Army adjust right now being already down to, and how will they kind of chip away and try to find those open opportunities for them to at least try to get one back to make this a real game?
A tripping call assessed to Brendan Connor, one of the milkmen for the Black Knights. And early here in the third period, the Ice Lions are going to have their second man advantage of the night to try and extend this lead to 3 goals. Schumann unable to control that puck at the blue line, and now resetting for the Ice Lions is Brendan Meyer. Meyer unable to get that puck to Schumann, and a hard shot there saved by Seafarth with the left pad.
Seafarth had to be alert there on that shot. He read it clearly through right off the blocker.
Meyer and Partridge trying to control the puck on the near side, closest to the broadcasting booth, and Mavris unable to control that one on the near side. Puck will go the length of the ice. Apologies for not having my mic set up, which should be number one priority coming into the third period, but we're here now. My name's Ethan Zaretsky, if I hadn't mentioned it already. Joined alongside me is Matt Gabramer, set for a very exciting third period, as this game is very within reach for Army. 2-goal lead for the Ice Lions with the man advantage for the next minute and 17 seconds. Army will get a full change defensively with 4 men on the ice.
And Ethan, the first 2 periods did tell 2 different stories. I mean, first period, both teams were locked in on that defense and that physical presence, very tight with their shots. They weren't really trying to find those open scenarios. They were really just trying to throw it on net. Second period, Penn State clicked more offensively than Army did. And that's okay for Army, because this game, we mentioned a million times already before, this game is not over yet. There's so much puck, so much clock left in the hockey game. 2-goal lead is kind of where Penn State kind of has that comfort with the cushion in their score.
Yep.
But if they didn't get a 3rd goal here, Ethan, it'd kind of almost be smelling like the dagger.
Shorthanded units are a key into this game. Both teams playing extremely well shorthanded, as both teams are looking to fend off some power play opportunities on each side. Unable to keep the puck on the near side was Mavris. Now going the other way was Lawrence. The shot steered away by Seafarth easily with the right pad. 45 seconds remaining on the man advantage for the Ice Lions, as they have their second power play unit out there, consisting of Schumann, Short, Mavris, Raimundo, and Knysner. Mavris sends the puck in, and he tacks the puck as Ice Lions have an opportunity here. Short, and he scores! His second of the game, it's Matthew Knysner! And it's 3-0 Ice Lions!
I mean, what a goal here, Ethan. Knysner, my apologies to his family listening, first time covering this team, but what a goal there, just rips it towards the net, and good things happen when you shoot the puck and you hit the net. You have a 4x6, Ethan, you gotta get it past the goalie, and guess what? That's what Knysner did, his second of the night, and this team is jumping right now.
It's a power play goal for the Ice Lions. Knysner tucks that one short side on Monahan, and the Ice Lions extend the lead to 3. 17:33 remaining here in the third period. Power play is over, as Knysner was able to convert on that power play for Penn State. Now retreating is Christian Short, going to be offsides here, but no call by the referee as the linesman really didn't see that one. Puck clearly traveled across the line, and now a chance here for the Black Knights trying to inch back at this deficit, and now a shot on blocked by Short. The rebound in front of the crease, where's the puck? Another shot by the Black Knights, unable to get it in the net. Cleared all the way around the board by Short. Crowd's loving that one as the puck's now on the near side. And finally, not to be able to clear it, and now hops over the stick there of Magnus Sheridan. Retrieving back for the Black Knights. A little bit of a sloppy play there. Now the Ice Lions are able to turn it over. Cabral Downs with a shot. Rebound, which just went wide of the net. Alec Connolly unable to stuff in that second opportunity chance. Now controlling the puck out of the defensive zone is Army, looking to go the other way, going across the red line and sending it all the way down. Picking up the puck defensively is Lambert, and he takes a big hit. Teammates looking for a penalty there. Now exchanging hits in the middle of the ice is Austin Lambert alongside number 70, James Delia. Two-on-one developing for Army as they look to cut back at this lead. Not able to get a shot on. Great defensive play there by Zachary Good.
I mean, Ethan, this Penn State team has been so good in front of us, in front of their goalie and C4 so far in this third period here. I mean, they even had that play 2-3 minutes ago where, I mean, everyone had to do their part and make sure that puck stayed out of the net and, I mean, not across that goal line.
Keeping the puck in offensively are the Black Knights. The puck is pinned down behind the right net of C4. All the way the length of the boards, Ice Lines pinned back in their defensive zone trying to clear the puck as Army has got to be desperate here to try and get a tally on the board. Riggle, one of the goal scorers for the Ice Lions, breaks their team out of the defensive zone intended for Connolly, not able to find his stick. Now a shot on, big block there by Goodness, is able to get his skate on that puck. Looking a little bit shaken up after taking that puck to the skate, but he picks up the puck defensively and looks to go the other way. Backhander was turned around there by Aronov. Great defensive stick there on the back check. Xander Faust still looking to get the puck out of the defensive zone for Penn State. Pinned back in there for at least the last minute. Retreating and looking to cycle the puck defensively for the Black Knights is Michael Fremgen. I haven't mentioned his name a ton tonight. Aronov now one-on-one going the other way with Cleary. Aronov with a shot on, hit the crossbar. Army is inches away from cutting at this lead, but Seaforth was having none of that. Deflected out in the netting and will have a face-off in Army's offensive zone.
And Ethan, I thought Seaforth actually got a piece of that before it went off the iron, so big opportunity there by Army. I mean, a shot from that far out with that speed. Seaforth had to react real quick. He does. Off the post, you better kiss that post later because it's still a good 3-0 lead for the Ice Lions.
Yep. Great play there by Raimundo to get the puck out of the defensive zone for the Ice Lions after the faceoff. Now an opportunity for Raimundo. He throws that puck on net. Great pass there from behind the net by Sebastian Kiley, who had a phenomenal game in yesterday's victory for the Ice Lions against the Big Red of Denison. Puck now cleared out of the zone. Aronov now going one-on-one against Schumann. Aronov hits the brakes and looks for some options, trying to get a passing lane. Able to do so on the far side. Now a wrister on the net of Seaforth just went wide. 14 minutes to go here in this one. Now chances for Army up happening a little bit more predominantly as they're very hungry to try and get on the score sheet tonight.
And if you're the Ice Lions here, Ethan, I mean, the scoreboard does say 3-0, but you cannot. There's so much clock left. You cannot let Army score and expose your defense in a terrible way. I mean, if they were going to beat them, they have to beat them on a really good shot, on a really good opportunity. You can't give it to them. But anytime you can give them a quick shot here, with all the time that we have, gets back to that 2-goal lead, and it could be that, you know, that turning point for Army that fuels them.
Army gets a full change on offense as they send out their second line consisting of Caleb Kaiser, centering James Delia and Henry Miller. Kai Holm now with the puck offensively for Army as he tries to send the puck into the middle of the slot intended there for Miller, unable to find his stick. Holm taken down, no penalty call as the puck is trapped in the far corner. Retrieving it now on the back end is Sheridan with a shot, hit the crossbar yet again. A couple of posts ring in there for Army as they're just inches away from gnawing back at this lead against the Ice Lions. More chances now developing for Army as they send the puck in front, stirred away by Seaforth. Another opportunity, puck is loose in the slot. Can Army get a stick on it? Yes, they can. Back at the top, Ice Lions desperately looking to clear this puck out of the zone. Looks like they're finally able to do so. Brendan Meyer going the other way, gaining the blue line with a shot on. Saved there easily by Monahan.
There's Brendan Meyer again taking a shot to the face, Ethan. I mean, I've mentioned that every time it's happened, so.
What happens predominantly with these physical games, Brendan Meyer taking a grunt of the hits and physical activity after the whistle. Must be something he's saying on the ice, or maybe he's just an easy target for other teams. Gonna have to talk about that with him this weekend as try to get some more information for the broadcast for you guys.
And Ethan, this is also a game that's actually, it's gone both ways because Penn State earlier on in that second period, they hit two posts and now it's went back and now it's equal for Army. They got two posts. So the post doesn't stray any shot, you know, it goes against both teams.
Shot on by Mavericks, grade A second opportunity there for Alec Connolly, just missed the net. As the Ice Lions are looking to get some of their fair share of offensive opportunities, trying to extend this lead to four goals. Puck is lifted up almost into the broadcasting booth, but now retrieving it for the Ice Lions is Alex Mavris, the Australian native, or rather their family might be, family and friends might be, but the shout out was given before the broadcast.
Shout out to our fans down under.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Gotta love the support from all around the country and honestly the United States and whole world of Earth, because last year we had Ryan Chu's family in on the broadcast all the way from Hong Kong, so we just love to see the support from absolutely everywhere. Where you can watch your YouTube feed of Penn State Ice Lions hockey. These two teams are going to be facing off tomorrow, so you're not going to miss that. You're not going to want to miss that second game to see if Army can try and create a different approach against this aggressive Ice Lions team. As Alec Connolly will throw a shot on there, that one was easily turned away there by Monahan.
As Penn State's just come out shooting this period, Ethan. I mean, any chance they can cross that blue line, they've just been throwing it right at the goalie and Monahan. So,
yep. Great analysis there, Matt, as they're just trying to get anything on Monahan. Maybe something will slip through. Try and extend this lead to more than three goals.
I think it's safe to say that, speaking of coach right before the game for the Ice Lions, I mean, what he wanted, getting the pucks in deep, he's...
Wow, Matt, what a phenomenal goal there by Xander Faust. Ethan Szymanski, the speedy freshman towards the right side, was able to drop off that pass for Xander Faust. What a goal by the Ice Lions, and they're able to take that 4-0 lead like we were just talking about, Matt.
I mean, that play was so fast, Ethan, we didn't even know what happened. It just tucked right under the goalie.
You were giving your great analysis there, and then the speedy Szymanski came down the right wall, dropped it back for Xander Faust, and he's able to tally on the goal.
And
there.
Ethan, guess what that is? That's another fourth line goal for this fourth line. They've been buzzing this entire weekend.
That second goal for this line, the first one came by Alec Riggle in the second period, the first goal of the game for the Ice Lions. Two by Kneisner on that other line, and now Xander Faust adding his name to the score sheet as the Ice Lions now extend their lead to four goals with 10 minutes and 56 seconds to go in this third period.
And this is how you make a statement, Ethan. I mean, you win a game 8-0.
Laying out there for a block shot. Referee's going to blow the whistle and converge on the near boards toward the left side. Is not sure who got their body in front of that shot, but hobbling off to the bench is Alec Riggle, so got to assume that he was taking the grunt of that shot. Ice Lions are definitely making him hear that one.
So, yeah, and then, Ethan, what I was going to say earlier was, how do you make a statement in front of your head coach in Chris Cunningham? I mean, you win 8-0 yesterday, and a lot of teams, after an 8-0 win, fans and everyone, even the bettors, too. I mean, I don't know if I'm allowed to say that here on this broadcast, but if you have a gambling problem, call 1-800-GAMBLER. But anytime a team comes out and wins 8-0, it's really nervous. How will they continue that momentum, and can they do that in the next game and come out here? I mean, this Ice Lions team, Ethan, 4-0 here in the third. They have not looked flat in this game. They've come out. They've wanted this game. They know they needed this game, and this is good. This game right here, and hopefully if they can hold on here and get this win, which hopefully they will, it's a big turning point for their season as they get back to 500.
The goal was announced to Ethan Szymanski. Not 100% sure he got the goal on that one, but he definitely set up that play, so credit to Szymanski, who I was talking about a little bit earlier, had a phenomenal game in yesterday's victory as the referee whistles a slashing call. We'll wait to see who that penalty is assessed to as the Ice Lions will look to get a change here offensively. Referees escorting Matthew Kneisner to forward for the Ice Lions with two goals tonight against the Black Knights. and now a golden opportunity for West Point to get a chance here and try and claw back out at the deficit that they currently have against Penn State. 10 minutes, 11 seconds to go here in the third period, Matt.
And this is a big opportunity here for the Black Knights. I mean, if they were to score within these first 30 seconds of this power play, it's like, okay, you get something going, you get the momentum, you know, you feel a little something on your stick, you feel something out of your skates. But right now, look at this, the ice lines, they're not letting them get into their zone. Look at this!
Alec Connolly with short-handed opportunity, what a move! And a great pad stop there by Monahan with the right pad. Great stop there as Alec Connolly was trying to bring that puck from his right to his left. Monahan took his right pad out there and was able to make the stop. Army now controlling possession of the puck in the offensive zone as they look to set up on their second power play of the game. Aronov now quarterback in this one as he sends it over. Rick and Wister just went above Seafarth. Controlling it now behind the net. Hard on the puck as Ryan Cleary as he lifts the puck out of the zone into safety for the Ice Lions. 1 minute and 7 seconds to go here on the man advantage for Army as they try and get one goal on the score sheet to try and, you know, create some momentum. Not even maybe in this game, but towards next game that they're going to play the Ice Lions, try and get some sort of momentum, maybe break the ice and break the seal of John Seafarth.
Seafarth looked really great in that tonight.
Sebastian Kiley, what a phenomenal shorthanded play. I mean, he's been all over the ice defensively with a man down for the Ice Lions. Just so noticeable there, and a big hit. And Zach Good was trying to lay the body there on a West Point defender, and then an opportunity right in front. Puck is loose. Referee doesn't blow the whistle, and now he finally does with some pushing and shoving right in front of the net, and Seafarth occurs. Both teams loving the aggressive play here after the whistles as 31 seconds remain on Ken Eisner's slash penalty.
Ethan, there's going to be guilty parties right now to be sorted out of.
Referees escorting Mavericks to the penalty box. Not sure what the penalties are going to be here on each side. Roughing penalty to Alex Mavericks. And now a troubled situation for the Ice Lions as Coach Cunningham is talking it over with his bunch. Specifically Joey Velarde, as they look to set up a defensive game plan here. Down two men, timeout, Army, and we'll step aside here for just a few moments as the teams are gonna talk it over here with 8:42 remaining in the third period. Straight out of the Black Knights timeout as they are going to look to set up here with a 5-on-3 advantage with 8:42 remaining in the third period. 31 second 5-on-3 for Army as the Ice Lions send out Cleary, Schumann, and their best shorthander this season so far, Sebastian Kiley, who had two shorthanded tackles in yesterday's battle against Tennyson.
Who's also made his presence on the ice shorthanded tonight, Ethan. And you even mentioned, too, I don't know, I believe if you said it late in a second or earlier here in the third, a big part of Penn State's success right now is their penalty kill tonight.
Absolutely, as Aronov sets up quarterbacking this 5-on-3 for the next 17 seconds for Army. Aronov now with the puck on the far side, looking to get some shots on here on Seafarth. Aronov walking in looking for an option. Cleary right in front of him, giving him some trouble. Now a shot opportunity here. Shot on one just went wide. Unable to catch the net of Seafarth. We're straight out of the box as Matthew Knysner, 5-on-4 now. Shot on bar down! And Army is on the board! Mark Lehman! What a shot from the top of the key!
A shot from the point by Army was point, and now it's a 4-1 game. And also, that was off the first expired penalty. So we will have even strength coming off this face-off. But what a rip, Ethan. Barred down. He doesn't get better than that.
The only player on the roster for Pennsylvania gets the first tally for the Black Knights tonight. And now it's a 4-1 game, completely changing the tides of this third period. 4-1 is the score for the Ice Lions. Team Steve back at even strength. Great way for the Black Knights to try and convert on their 5-on-3 advantage. Just wanted to note it. Just wanted to note that Kyle Lawrence is also from Pennsylvania, so made a mistake there. Thought I was getting a nifty stat there. Got a little bit too cocky, but it is what it is as a broadcaster. You're just trying to think of anything that you can do to intrigue the listener.
We got excited because we saw a really cool goal. I mean, bar down, yeah. He doesn't get better than that. Best noise in hockey.
Partridge, that pass was too far for his stick, as he'll retrieve it back behind the net. And Monahan, Army looking to buzz here now with its final, but they're able to get their first tally of the night here in the third period. Now an opportunity offensively as the shots on goal are 28-30 now in favor of Army, and they got a plethora of shots there on the 5-on-3. Great advantage there for Army. They're looking to carry some of that momentum into the next couple minutes. 7-17 remaining in the third period, and it's definitely going to be very important. That goal seems to be really, it's going to be really big in this weekend's narrative as these two teams are going to be facing off tomorrow in a game that can really decide maybe if these teams have any playoff implications, because both of these teams are extremely elite.
And also too, Ethan, I mean, a big takeaway right now for Army, regardless of there still being 7 minutes left in this game. I mean, they finally got one on the board, yep. And that kind of breaks their own, you know, scoring deadlock. So that can kind of get guys feeling. I mean, especially for someone like Lehman too. I mean, now he knows what it's like to score here at Pegula, and hopefully they can try to continue it and make this game a little bit closer.
Lehman, the big body forward, you cannot miss him when he's on the ice. Got to check the stats here on how tall Lehman is. Doesn't say how tall he is, but he's 220 pounds, so a big boy there on the forward group. He is normally paired up with Aronov and Gosher. We have face-off to the left of Seafarm in the Ice Lions defensive zone as the referees chit-chat and try to figure out some issues that are going on. Having a conversation with one of the members of the far corner of the Blue Ice Arena. As we will take a break with 6:32 remaining in the third period, we'll be back very shortly.
6-7.
Not sure what the confusion was there, but the ice crew was out there at Pagula scooping up or whatever it was in front of the Army West Point bench, or rather that is the Army Black Knights. The back of their jerseys say West Point, which is why I just previously said that, but that's the location of where they're at in comparison to New York, where this team is located. Army got here yesterday, so a bit of time to acclimate to Penn State, get to explore State College and all of its beauty of an amazing weekend that we've had so far here in State College. It feels like October's been a lot better than September.
Honestly, you're right, Ethan. I mean, these last few days here, and if you're listening here and you know what's going on here in Happy Valley, I mean, we had some heat waves recently. I mean, yeah. 75, 76, maybe 77, 78.
And it's cold. As we're talking about the weather, Army doesn't care because they're cutting the lead back to two goals. A great shot there by Wyatt Symmatris, and with his family in attendance, he gets on the board.
I mean, what a story that is right there that you just mentioned, but guess what, Ethan? 6 minutes left to go in this game. Two-goal lead. This game is not over.
Two quick goals there by the Black Knights, and now looking a little bit. Now a timeout there by Chris Cunningham. Great call there by Coach Cunningham to, you know, settle his team down right out of the break. We're going to have another one TV timeout here before the ice lines. We'll be right back. Right out of the Penn State Ice Lions timeout. If you're just joining us, Wyatt Symmatris with the most recent goal for the Black Knights, making this a two-goal game and a save by Seafarth right out of the break. 6:06 to go, and we got a game here, Matt. It was a 4-0 lead for the Ice Lions just a few minutes ago, but now what are you seeing?
And I want to talk about the goalie, John Seaforth, right now, Ethan. I mean, that first goal he gave up was really not really his fault. I mean, his teammates were a little too undisciplined. There was a 5-on-3 opportunity. There's a lot of plethora of shots coming on that 5-on-3 opportunity. They finally struck when the player came out of the box. So there was a lot of opportunities they had when he was skating back to join the 5-on-4 rush. But that one was the first goal that really, truly beat Seaforth. So yep. He's looked really good in net tonight. But now it's how can he adjust here with just under 6 to go? And can he hold his for his team?
The Black Knights looking really, really good so far out of that break. Two goals there really propelled their momentum thus far. As the Ice Lions looking a little bit sloppy there on defense. But now as I say that, they have an opportunity. Almost that, but that was taken away there quickly by Magnus Sheridan, the one Auckland, Wisconsin native for Army, circling there behind the net to the left side. Ice Lions playing very defensively.
Great defense there by Cabrel Downs.
Oh, yep, definitely. He's showing himself that he's really proving as a big freshman in this class for the Ice Lions, able to do a lot of work offensively and defensively as Schumann shows up a couple Black Knights there in the far corner. And now Cabrel Downs, who we just mentioned, takes a big hit, taken down. Not sure what the referee was looking at there. Taken down was Cabrel Downs, no call, but Army sends the puck the length of the ice. It's gonna be an icing on the Black Knights.
As the captain of Army, in number 17, Anthony Chambers, did not appreciate the freshman. I called him a rookie, I mean, he really is, but in Carson Cabrel Downs, bringing him down like that with the shoulder grab, but sometimes when you lock on the players like that, Ethan, it just happens in the moment. So,
speaking of Chambers, want to give a big shout out to the Chambers family watching. Both the Army Chambers and the Chambers that I'm referring to, you know who you are. Thank you so much for tuning into today's stream and joining us and the Penn State Lions today on a beautiful day here at Pagula Ice Arena.
And Ethan, I also want to shout out my beautiful family because this is my first time calling an Ice Lions game and they're all tuned in right now. So.
I love that. Thank you so much for showing support to Brown family and company. Thank you so much for being with us on a late afternoon here in State College, Pennsylvania, as the Ice Lions now lead this game 4-2. Two quick goals by West Point proved to be a big part of this third period as they're trying to cut this lead back in half and make this a one-goal game. carrying the puck into the offensive zone is Henry Miller, the freshman from Chicago. Poor West put a shot on. Seaforth didn't see that one until it hit the boards. Now with the puck on the near side, three ice lines battle against three Black Knights for possession of the puck. And now getting out of there, are the ice lines, Xander Faust now with the puck, clearing it on the far side. Controlling it is Aronov, the top line out there for the Black Knights as they look to generate some offense here with the dying 4 minutes here in this game. Szymanski now hard on the puck for the ice lines, creating a turnover. Xander Faust with the backhander, the rebound's there, Szymanski unable to get his stick on it. Tired group out there for the ice lines. The puck is sent the length of the ice. Christian Short is going to be there to touch up. And with 3:52 to go in the third period, this one's getting really, really sweaty.
I mean, Ethan, right there, the ice lines had an opportunity to really put the dagger in this game. And I know Army's had a little bit of momentum right now trying to come back. But a goal right now by the ice lines, it should really seal the deal for me personally. They've done a little bit better since that timeout called by Cunningham, and they've been a little bit more defensive. So, and we were talking about Cabrel Downs earlier. I mean, he skated with that one player of Army the entire time he was on the ice. So,
yep, great analysis there, Ben. Is of Matt? I say Ben. Sorry, Matt.
And shout out to Ben Wasserman.
So used to being alongside Ben Wasserman, who's unable to join us this weekend. But you know, Matt, you're probably gonna take Ben's spot. So, you know, don't tell him that unless you're watching, Ben. Sorry about that. But with 3:30 to go, Army is looking really desperate to try and get this to a one-goal game. They only need one more, but this game is well within reach for the Black Knights. Trying to send the puck on net there at the blue line there was Magnus Sheridan, unable to do so. Great defensive stick there by Matthew Knysner.
Ethan, I honestly rather watch these two teams play than any New Jersey Devil game that Ben Washman watches.
No need for that trip there, but another chance there for Army as they try to throw the puck on net as much as possible here within the last final five of this third period. Another opportunity there, trying to throw that one in front was Kai Holm. Unable to do so, is now retreating for the ice lines as Christian Short, able to clear the zone there. Tip pass there by Sebastian Kylie. A little bit of confusion from both teams. Ice lines didn't think that that was an icing as Kylie looked to have touched it before the red line. So we're gonna have a face-off to the right of John Seaforth. With 2:44 remaining in the third period, Matt. The ice lines need to be very careful here to be defensively sound against this strong Army forward.
Hey, Ethan, it was just about under 3 minutes left to go, two-goal game. Don't be surprised if Liam Monahan comes out of net here if Army can get a good possession here in their zone, in their offensive zone.
As we see, Monahan has been really strong in net tonight. 31 saves for him. Rather, it's 28 saves for Monahan. 33 for Seaforth. Can't do my math, that's why I'm a communications major. But nonetheless, 2 minutes and 15 seconds to go in this bout between the Army Black Knights and the Penn State Ice Lions. You do not want to miss the game two of this series. It's going to turning out to be a really hard-fought battle. And two teams who are looking to extend on their great season so far. 2-3 are the Ice Lions, but they're coming off two big wins. And Army is 3-1-1. Having an overtime loss to Rowan. A 2-on-2 developing for Army. Now they get their third attacker in. A shot on, didn't go into that. Seaforth, but a big juicy rebound was cleared there by Meyer. Going the other way is Meyer now with the puck on the far side. Puck is chipped into the offensive zone for the ice lines. 1:30 to go, and the goalie is pulled. Monahan is on the bench, but the puck is in the defensive zone of the Black Knights. Here comes an opportunity for the ice lines to seal it, and a backhand, another chance. Puck was in the slot, now it's in the near corner. Empty net for West Point, but the puck is now trapped in their defensive zone as they look to set up offensively. Still with the puck in their defensive zone. Battling with their sticks in the far corner is Carson Cabrel Downs with Evan Partridge. Now putting the puck in front, and there is the dagger! Joey Valerdi puts this game home.
What a play, Ethan, and it happened again right in front of the goaltender in Seaforth. I mean, I believe you did say the wrong name. It was Xander Faust who cleaned that puck up,
yep.
Swatted it out the way. I mean, it was a big loopy chance there for the Black Knights to make it a one-goal game. And guess what? It's back to a three-goal lead, and that should be that calling card here for the Ice Lions. 1:10 left to go, but right now I think they've done enough in this game. They looked really good, both sides of the puck. Both teams started off really strong, but it was Penn State who was able to adjust. And there was times in this game where Army was able to adjust late in this third, but Penn State's able to take it back and hopefully wind down these last minute.
It was Xander, actually, rather, was Joey Velarde, who was at the beginning of that Ice Line celebratory lineup there, cheering on the rest of the bench. 50 seconds to go here in the third period. Ice Lions now lead by three, back to what it was before, and that was shot on, saved by Seafarth with the pad. And if you're the Ice Lions, whoa, there's a little extracurriculars there after the play. Is you definitely want to, you know, keep the tensions low, because these two teams are going to be going at each other again tomorrow, like I keep talking about. Charlie Aronoff is going to be heading to the bench for an extracurricular penalty after that play. A tripping penalty after that whistle. It's going to be a power play for the Ice Lions with 43 seconds to go in this third period. Referees are going to send all the players the length of the ice to the other side in the defensive zone of the Black Knights.
I love the energy out of several downs. Chirping, I believe, in Aronoff going to the box. But guess what? These guys got to see if they can play against him tomorrow, Ethan. And I'm really excited about this game. I'm going to be checking in with you. Unfortunately, I cannot be here tomorrow. I really wish I can, but I'm going to stay tuned in, though.
We're going to have Owen Gelber on the call tomorrow, being our color commentator. Two brand new colors coming in this weekend, stepping in for the great Ben Wasserman and Paige Clark, who are unable to make it this weekend for the games against the Black Knights. Now walking in, looking for a shot, had a wide open net and a goal! That's Alex Mavris! Believe it's his first of the season, but nonetheless, it's now a four-goal advantage, right back to where it was for the Ice Lions.
I mean, what a rip from the point, and I mean, saw the open space on the glove side of attendee in Monahan and still ripped it home and beat some glove side. We have a four-goal lead, and the Lions can actually now take a bow.
I saw that wide open netting there that Mavris also saw from the broadcasting standpoint. Everyone cheering on Mavris as he got his first goal in this game. 6-2 lead now for the Ice Lions, and this one's well out of reach. It was a power play goal there because of the penalty assessed to Charlie Aronoff after that one play. 23 seconds to go in this one. Definitely want both of these teams, or especially if you're the Ice Lions, want to keep the tensions low, because you don't want to be ticking off the Black Knights going into a second game, because they're a big, strong, aggressive team, and if you get on their wrong side, they can definitely keep games physical.
100%, Ethan, as the time will expire here.
3-2-1. The Ice Lions have a three-game win streak. And I didn't shout out Austria Garcia, but now I get an opportunity to do so, walking by the broadcasting booth. Shout out Garcia. Ice Lions win. The score is 6-2 here at Pagula Ice Arena as we send you back ringside. Ethan Zaretsky joined alongside Mark Abram. What were the big keys that you saw from the Ice Lions in this dominant 6-2 victory?
Definitely the turnaround in the second period, Ethan. I mean, very tight game in that first period. We saw the physicality, and, you know, they were able to finally break down the Black Knights defensively, score those goals. They were big, big, big chances where they scored off rebounds right in front of the net. Mm-hmm. Get your sticks to the net. Good things will happen. And there was a little moment where the defense kind of slipped up a little bit, and guess what? They were able to get back They got back to be big, playing very tight defensively, and they were not able to let Army walk away with the win here tonight. And very shout out to Seifert in his first start of the year. Gets the win tonight. Looked really good in net. And yeah, I mean, this was a team win, Ethan. And it came from the fourth line again, the fourth line story. Two goals from the fourth line, two goals out of Kneiser. I mean, this was a really great team. Really great team win here tonight.
As the greatest tradition in hockey unfolds right in front of us. Thank you so much for tuning into tonight's broadcast between the Penn State Ice Lions and the Army Black Knights. You do not want to miss game 2 of this series tomorrow. We will see you then.